Summer's almost over, the winter's on its way. All that snow and ice made me wonder, why is it so hard to make ice using ice? Take a little bit of really cold water and put lots of ice in it. If we have that much ice in there, why doesn't the water freeze? We've been told that water starts freezing at 0 degrees Celsius, but that's not what we see here. Why? Freezers are a very cool invention. Imagine that. With just one flip of the switch, you can create a very cold spot in your house where you can throw away stuff to prevent them from spoiling. Neat. Creating ice is no problem for us today, but did people create and use ice in the past too? Yes, people who could afford that kind of luxury. We found that people collected and stored ice up to 3 millennia ago. They would collect the ice in the winter from the frozen rivers and lakes, and they would store that ice in correctly named ice houses. With good enough insulation, the ice would last up to the next winter even. But how did they manage to keep the ice icy for so long? That's the story for another video. Now let's go back to our first question. Why we can't create ice using ice? Because of the latent heat. You see, if you put an ice cube out of the freezer, it will relatively quickly go from minus 20 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees, but it won't melt just yet. It will enter so-called constant temperature process. This is where ice will need the most energy to transform from solid into a liquid. While staying at 0 degrees, ice will still take the energy from its surrounding without changing its temperature. And this blew me away. During this constant temperature process, ice will use enough energy to turn into a liquid, as ice from minus 170 degrees Celsius would need to go to a 0 degrees. This is why when you're trying to cool something down with ice, the initial temperature of it is mostly irrelevant.